Top land, that's probably the first and the water. This is actually,
This is the river that you were talking about?
That's actually an oxbow lake, the river is a little further over. That's an old riverbed as well, a nice little place, meandered back and forth across there. And, this area used to be before the experiment station, a fish hatchery down there. That's the reason it's got so many little ponds. And actually, it shows a whole series of them. But about 2 years ago, those three dams right there blew out one Thursday night right before Christmas.
Ooh.
And, you're in a big rainstorm, y'all probably remember that, 'cause about every road around here, they had a creek got covered over.
And then it goes from this up to some of the classrooms. This is
standard size, the Firestone, radial all traction, 23 degrees, same size. We're gonna be testing a Michelin XM108, which is a low profile tire that also fits on the same 38 inch rim. I believe if, without actually turning my notes, it's a 665R38, is that right, Ed?
Yep.
Then we're going to be testing a Goodyear, and I think it turns out that it's a DT710. This is an R1W tire. This is also an R1W, and so is this one. These are R1s, these are R1s. And the difference being that an R1 has got a certain amount of tread depth, and I think you guys are all familiar with it. An R1W has got about 25 to 40% more tread depth. It's a European type of tread design, and of course, the competitors are starting to come out with the same type tire with the increased tread depth, etc., for more traction. And it's sort of halfway in between an R1 and an R2. And the idea is that we're going to go in and hopefully going to pick out a field that's fairly homogeneous, meaning that as flat as possible, or if there's a slope, that the slope is basically the same from one end to the other, if at all possible, and that the soil is hopefully the same all the way across the field. And we'll start out, and we're going to have somewhere in the neighborhood of about a test run of about absolute bare minimum of 100 yards, and it needs to be probably more like 150 yards a test run. But we're going to need some room on the ends to turn around, and also to get the implement in the ground, get the speed regulated, and get everything stabilized before we go past the goal line. And we'll just call this the goal line and the finish line. And basically, the tractor will start out, and whenever we pass the start line, we'll start every morning at about 7:30, 7:45, and we, you know, if we can cut the boom truck loose, we absolutely have no need whatsoever for him. Who knows, 3:30, 4 o'clock, then no problem. But if we're in a bind, things aren't going right,
I remember there was some wet spots in there.
It's going to be
on that right corner in the back or in the middle.
There's still a gummy soil.
It's got a drain tile under it. So you would think this would get real boggy in here, but it don't. Mm-hmm.
There's a drain tile under the field.
Mm-hmm. It drains.
See, here's number, what I call the area number three back over there that was up. Mm-hmm.
It's getting hit probably in the woods over there, so it can't come. Actually, 14 acres, like, you know, this looks a little bigger, but 14 acres here, 11 or 12, you know, on this side.
Okay.
But,
like that whole entire this and it doesn't look like it. If he's saying
so, we had a lot of debris, more than I thought. I thought the V-Ripper would go through it, and we still, you can tell we still had trouble. He's dragging a little bit. The most trouble we have is down in that gray.
No, it's not really all that wet here right now.
We talk about depth to clay, and it can be 0 to 14 inches to 18 inches to 2 feet, and you can see it in the one field, you know, a right, built-in trauma.
And there's part of it that the stalks hadn't been mowed yet.
Yeah. Last time I talked with Glenn, he said they still have some data to collect on it.
But they'll be finished by the time we...
Should be. They promised me it's going to be finished last week. I was going to plant wheat. Should be able to look at the yellow paper.
Probably going to end up staying at the Holiday Inn Express. I mean, that seems fine. But for some reason, we this would be the place where we could do our mountain exercise?
That'd be just for video.
Yeah.
Tell you what happened to us. Talking about, you know, how to play.
Yeah, that's good. Yeah, I'll focus in on that. Yeah, would you like to repeat that?
Brad's better side.
How are you, sir?
Okay, good.
I'm sorry to be bothering you and your wife so much today here.
That's all right.
Took everything, all the data that you gave me a little earlier today and sat down and worked through it.
Mm-hmm.
And I have a recommendation for you with reference to the pressure in your tires. In those rear tires, the most critical situation is going to be when you've got the cultivator on and got it lifted up and you're running down the road, roading it.
Correct.
That's going to be when you have the heaviest load, or at least, you know, from what you told me.
Yeah.
With that, and what I did is I took the shipping weight on that tractor that you indicated was very similar, a K6105 two-wheel drive. Indicates in the book that the shipping weight on that is real close to 11,000 pounds. It's about 10,830 pounds.
Mm-hmm.
So I assume that your tractor probably would be real similar.
Yeah, it might be just a little heavier, maybe 12.
Yes, sir. At any rate, I took that and made a further assumption, and you may want to verify this, but I assume that 30% of that weight would be on the front axle and 70% would be on the rear axle. That's fairly typical. If you look at that, if your tractor weighed 11,000 pounds, then you'd have 7,700 pounds on it.
Set Bruce up there, or Bruce Wynn, and he picked it up from a loser. So they were doing over $200,000 a month in the store.
Wow.
And they came into Bruce one day and said, "Your history." And Now, this is a mother and brother talking to a son and a brother. And Bruce almost went crazy because he just bought a house up there, you know. And I...
Now, is that the same as the Pirelli?
Yeah. The question I'd have on this thing, the lot, I mean, that's old Goodrich tread design.
Really?
Yeah. This is it. This is basically the Goodrich mold that was sold to Armstrong, and it now has been sold.
So far like this?
Yeah.
Over here, I marked it. Go all the way around.
Mud shade. That seems to work very well.
You write GY on it, Ed, please.
In certain applications works fine.
Is that an R2, Ed?
No, these are not R2s. He's just showing them.
That's a 23 degree bar there, right?
Yeah. Where the rubber is changed.
Check. Clear case of steel damage.
So they ran into that year before. And that one, that laminate now there.
Edged to the useful.
Yeah.
that you want to have no live out here. All right.
We just see work.
You over here to chop this cat and chow him.
Yeah.
How do you all like that thing?
Oh, it don't break no much of this thing. We're going to get another next year bigger than that.
Ideally, it dries out just enough where whenever you want to get in there and work it, it's not that difficult. But like you said, you know.
This is ideal farm conditions right now. This is ideal, but it does all those different things. This is as perfect as it gets. I haven't had any ideas. I mean, I've seen rice fields that are just completely flat from the wind. I mean, they have such a good crop that the hedge is so heavy and the wind comes down and flattens.
Yeah.
So that's the problem. After they've been bush hogged.
After they've been mowed down and they go in to disc them under there. Really. That's a...
don't think this is real, the gumbo. I don't think this is gumbo here. Ed?
I think this is right a fair amount. Passes the ribbon test. Definitely make a ribbon out of it. That. Maybe this is what he's talking about. I don't know.
He's going about 40 miles an hour.
Is he actually putting something down?
Yeah, he is. He's way over there, though. He's going to come by now.
Our tractors that's covering the seed there running about 8 mile an hour, anywhere from 7.5 to 9. One of them's probably running 9, the other's running about 7.5.
What do you have running on those?
To give himself room to turn, I guess.
Right.
So he don't miss any.
We went to see out there in
triangle tells you it's a 90s decade. It's a 94 tire.
I don't know what the triangle means.
In the truck tire, that triangle means it's a 90s decade tire.
Right. It might mean that on the other, but I mean on the 10 years on the tire, it's pretty much where you want.
I shouldn't have looked at that.
Wonder what
57 right here.
Ask, hold on just a second, okay. Ask Bruce what he thinks.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Wow.
So it's gonna take. It's take.
Thank you.
Well, the thing that, I guess,
try and pull it out, Brad. See how hard it is to pull out. Yep.
Ground where he turns right here.
Yep.
Ooh, a cut on that tail.
Yep. It almost looks like where he caught it with one of these discs. What it looks like. Sure it does. Now see this one here. That must be for spreading it out. This one is for pulling it together, right?
Yep.
You got a small disc on the outside and big disc on the middle. That old stuff that sticks to the bottom of your feet and never get it off.
Yep. Let's have a look, see what happens when you squeeze it.
You can feel it sticking to your fingers. That's right off the bat. Sandy soil.
It's good. Dream house in downtown England in
Totally different. Totally different.
Unbelievable.
Yeah.
10 times more pleasant than the farmers people associated with agriculture.
I know it.
The truck is there. Always in a hurry, it's always a mad dash. They never have 2 seconds to hurry, much less speed.
In order to do that, we've got to make sure that the contract's set.
Titan earlier was an Armstrong mold.
Be an old Firestone plant that closed down. Quite a few people bought it. Like a Fidelity, same thing as a Fidelity.
With the forestry skidders.
I agree, Ed.
In this part of Kansas. Arkansas, not Kansas. Zoom in.
Yeah. Sweep across the field just to see if it is. Yeah, keep driving. Yeah,
this is cotton bales just outside of Waco, Texas.
They do with cottonseed is they sell it to ranchers in feedlots to feed the cattle and sheep and stuff.
Cattle eat that?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, and they either grind it up or they just mix it in with regular feed or whatever.
Enough seed the whole state of Texas. That's fine.
No, this right here? Yeah, I don't know what
it is. Of course,
I don't know what it is.
This is what they picked there. Not enough with.
Yeah.
Oh, right. Yeah. Understood. Okay, I got it.
Between now and 15
that's something we don't want to get into. We've even talked about putting chain link fence all around this, you know, property towards the back and stacking out there. But can you,
$125, Kelly.
Kelly Springfield does not put Kelly chain on it. It's generic. But you buy them from Monarch or TBC or whoever.
I see. They did that so that people could sell them sort of as their neutral.
Kind of except neutral. Everybody's selling neutral. So.
Yeah.
See, like
yeah.
This same fire here, if you order it, really we have it in the power. Right. This fire is power.
Yeah.
Is some good useful information.
I'd recommend you to start on the highway.
Okay.
Make these two and put them on top of each other.
Yeah.
You just look like jumbled, very confused.
Yeah.
We could have two small ones. One slot, you know, on one screen, shrink this and break that down.
Track down your own treasure. We'll put it all together next.
You're watching Lifetime, television for women.
Watch out! There's something funny going on. It tickled me, Elmo. Your child tickles Elmo, and he talks about the huggable members of the Tyco Sesame Street family. Before it cracks.
It's good for sparring when we're competitive. Yeah, cool. This is gonna blow your mind, Internet. Will you be able to do
the admin? Thank you all that, Will. We don't want to turn this. You know, I think it's going to be so easy. My house is just, it's a great thing to have, but. I get around and, like, there's a hole there, so I'm just dropping some shit. Come on, get there. Go take his best shot.
We won! The problem is it cooks a lot faster on the outside than it does on the inside, so how often you have to put them up higher or whatever because it can burn them on the inside and you don't. Yeah. Oh my. Scott has a really nice salad feast in there. We might want to go in there and go ahead and start eating salad in there.
And then ranch, and then Italian parmesan, and zesty Italian, the stuff that you like.
Zesty Italian, okay, that's what I like, man. Yeah.
Alright, and it's like, what's that roll in there?
You got all in there? Okay.
Now, what exactly is easy?
Wait a minute, was that Italian parmesan and ranch three different kinds?
No, Italian parmesan is one.
If you guys are going to go to the office work tomorrow, I'll probably see you there because I've got a lot of work to do. I've got to get in there and get my office moved, and I've got a ton of stuff that I need to get done. So
you're going to have to repeat that once again. Go on. What I have to do is remember not to step back, which is something.
I'm gonna go get some more.
The main land here for the feeding research facility is part of it.
All right. Well documented. It's good, isn't it? That is. Maybe order them, though, because they make it a lot easier to take. You got this one, sir? It's locked. Oh, goodness. Have to start the engine up in order to rotate the tire. Yeah.
There's a hole here, a wall there, and a hole here. Well, the distance, it's not holding any. We're letting them out this way, but you need to put on your safety glasses. And if you're in gloves, the wheels are locked. This is the guy.
Thank you.
19.9.
Yeah, it's like, it's changing the screen.
I know, that's what I'm saying now. I know, yeah, absolutely. If we're looking at a digital camera now, we can see you.
Thank you.
Looks like I'm not my nose.
I'll tell you what, I got this down. Yeah, I've got that down. I've watched you do once more like this. No, that's what you got to do. You got to get points.
I'm going to have that.
I'm going to tell you. Yeah. You get points about two revolutions.
Was the Amber Bibna, this is the XM108 before it, Double whatever, so I need a few extra runs.